Hey everyone, how's it going? My name's Mayuko, and in this video, we're going to be learning about a technology in under 2 minutes. This is part of a series where I introduce concepts, explain things in an easy to understand way, and give you the foundation that you need to dive deeper on your own. This is Tech in 2. The topic for today is backend development, so let's start that timer. So in order to talk about backend development, let's revisit what front-end development is. It's the practice of creating user interfaces that are flexible and make it easy for a user to interact with data. Backend development is a practice of creating those plugs into the data, oftentimes called an application program interface or API. I honestly like to think of the backend as like a panel of plugs, where each plug returns a massaged subset of the data, and the panel itself hides away all the complexity of fetching from and updating to the database. Unlike front-end development, backend isn't specific to any one platform. In fact, it serves as more like a foundation that supports whatever platform sit on top of it. So to illustrate this, let's go back to our ATM analogy. So when a user wants to withdraw $40 from their account, they'll tap on various buttons on the machine, or our UI in this case, that then communicates to the backend to actually carry out those tasks. Now let's go back to the panel of plugs visualization. Imagine the front end plugs into one plug called Get Money. That plug actually connects to several other plugs on the wall to do the business logic. For instance, one to check that the user actually has $40 in their account, and the other to subtract that amount from their balance. Developing each of those plugs is backend development to make sure that the user interacts with the data safely. So, what's in the stack? Well, usually it involves two types of languages. One is a server-side programming language that helps build the API itself. Commonly used are Python, Java, Ruby, PHP, and JavaScript. And the second is a SQL language to actually fetch the data from the database. And what are the important factors and skills for working in backend development? One is to have the architectural skills for making well-organized, extensible, and testable code. A big part of backend is organizing logic and data, so those skills allow for writing code with speed and quality. And the second is to communicate clearly with front-end developers. There's a myth that backend developers don't need to know anything about users, which is wrong, by the way. Backend developers are a big part of allowing users do what they need to do to get done, so it's a joint effort between front-end developers and backend developers to write code to do just this. And that is backend development. And that's it for this episode of Tech in 2. The next episode is something that I know a lot about, which is mobile development. And so make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out. Comment down below any topics you'd like to see explained in 2 minutes, and I will see you next time. Bye.